live stream right now on my Facebook, and it's going to be a cut and projected tomorrow on this stream. For the concert to start, I would like to ask you if you can leave your bags and coats wherever you want. And please stand up and let's try walking around the room. So let's try to listen to the room. Try to listen to the sound of our footsteps.
Could you repeat what are
yes.
we trying to do?
Let's try to listen to the sound that our footsteps make when we walk.
Don't try.
Let's try to be as quiet as possible. Let's try to walk as quietly as possible. And try to look everyone in the eyes. And now stop where you are. So I would like to explain what we're going to do from now on. Please pay attention if it is possible and maybe come a bit closer. I know that the acoustics of this room are not very helpful for that situation. So let's say that our goal for today will be to figure out all the structures, all the mediations that are connected to us being here and in according to other people inside this room. So we will propose a simple structure to do that. Each person can take his or her turn to say one phrase and all the others will repeat the same phrase so that everyone will be able to hear no matter where they are standing in the room. So one phrase that will explain our existence inside this space, inside this particular art space where a performance is occurring. And we continue walking in the process as we're speaking. Why did you come to Documenta? Why did you come to Documenta?
Das Treiben hier ist konfus.
Is this a concert?
There is nothing going on.
There is nothing going on.
Is there an echo?
Is there an echo? Feed your ego. Why are we here?
Why are we here?
Good question.
Good question.
Yeah.
This is how we walk. Is there a shore? Let's go backwards.
We prefer going backwards.
We prefer going backwards.
I'd like to have a drink.
I'd like to have a drink.
Please don't repeat this sentence.
Please don't repeat this sentence. Is this the only thing we can do together?
Let's sing.
Let's sing.
Let's
dance together. I paid to be here.
I paid to be here.
But I am a bit bored.
But I am a bit bored.
What should we do?
What should we do?
Entertain
us.
We have to entertain ourselves.
We have to entertain ourselves. What we do is just walking around is boring. Let's have a break. Some people want to go. Can you give us some feedback?
Can you give us some feedback?
Can you give us some feedback?
I'm so free.
I'm so free. I feel trapped. I feel tiny. My feet are hurting.
I'm tired of walking in circles.
I'm tired of walking in circles.
We can stop.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Is there free internet access here?
What's the I-we relation?
Because it feels like it.
There is no music.
There is no music.
Let's make music.
Let's make music.
What's music?
What is music?
Let's walk again.
What are we doing here? We are having a concert.
Is this an experiment?
But why?
It's getting boring.
Just because we expected something different. does it end?
What did you expect?
What did you expect?
Music.
Singing.
Harmony.
Only 10 minutes of torture left.
I believe it has something to do with alienation.
I believe it has something to do with alienation. Is it a job? Is it well paid? Let's have a circle.
Oops.
Thank you.
some tea.
It was very.
Nah.
We will send our friends tomorrow. They will stay the floor.
We will send our friends tomorrow.
Great performance.
Bye. Thank you.
What comes after art?
Food.
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 Football.
Football.
Can you repeat it again?
Give us at least some feedback.
Can you give us some feedback?
Can you give us some feedback?
Why are you leaving?
Why are you leaving?
Why are you leaving?
Just tell us two words about your experience.
So, not a great experience, it was just, okay, we see people acting.
Who is acting most? No, I asked, who is acting most out of all of us?
Ich habe nicht verstanden, was du gesagt hast. I didn't understand her, so I can't answer.
Who is acting? She said we saw some people acting, and then Eleni asked her who is acting.
Oh, okay. I don't know. Ask her.
Not that much complex if you just repeat like quite easy sentence, like phrases. It always stays like just on a really low level of a discourse or something. On the other side, I also find you're kind of filming people when they're leaving, also when they're talking. I don't know, a little bit weird in a way. Do you understand what I mean? It's a kind of, yeah, I don't know, putting the camera on if something happening.
Yes, but if I don't come here,
yeah,
near, the sound will not be good.
Yeah, I just want to like tell you how it's also have another kind of style. It's a kind of, I don't know, news camera style to go really close to the people and let them explain why they want to leave if they don't like it. It changes the room.
We said it from the start, though.
No, it's not. I just want to like tell you that there's like different things going on. That's like this also working, and on the other side, it's also absolutely not working.
We can use this. We don't want to repeat.
I would be interested in what kind of experience you made in the last performance. I don't know, that would be my interest. Maybe you could tell us, if you like. We can also do something else.
Why would you like to learn about the previous performance?
Because if you say you're looking for a collective subject, I'm really interested in this kind of game, like call it. yeah, I don't know, it could like get you to a point like this. I've done it
and
experienced
that
it works, but I'm curious, maybe it does.
The question is, do you want to find a collective subject in this space?
As I said, I think it needs a little bit more than just like giving the power to a group in a kind of frame to get something like this.
Like?
You need a room where you can like discuss about real things and agree about something. Not just like walking around, it's like not a collective subject that everyone walks like a tiger in a cage in a circle. Like it's happened before. It's also interesting. I'm just saying that how should we empower the group? I'm just curious if there's something which happened in the last performances. But we can also continue with the game, and I don't want to be like taking too much space.
When we try to agree, it happens that someone tries to stand out. So it's very difficult to agree. I'm trying to agree with something.
Perhaps we agree that we stop the camera.
Why? Can you explain why?
Yes,
why?
I say something and the camera will come to me, but when we don't come together, I think the first step is to stop the camera.
Yeah, but this is part of the experience.
No, wait, we have to vote for it. I disagree with turning off the camera because there are people that are watching us and they want to continue watch, and they have also watched the previous performances. They are interested in this piece and they want to continue watching it. So the camera is part of the piece, and also there are other people that are not here and want to watch and participate in this experience. So I disagree. We can vote about it.
And do you ever think about that maybe the camera is something which stands in the way between like a social construct, and I mean it makes people less free for the camera.
The camera is exactly what she said. It's part of the dream. Everybody knew when you walked in this door that you were going to be recorded and you don't like it.
No, it's fine. It's okay. I'm just saying that if you want to like collect a thing, a camera is
maybe
not
the
right.
You're talking about a subject and where did you meet them? That's their goal.
That's like the last sentence in this nice paper.
So, should we find the collective subject because it is written in a piece of paper?
No, we don't have to. I'm fine with not having
a discussion. But we can find the collective subject in the game when we look to the other eyes. We can go around the game. In this game, I can look to the other eyes and look at the part of the. It's not only the word of the doing.
Yeah. But I agree with what you say, that repetition blocks the development of finding any kind of subject. So we wasted our time for 35 minutes. Because we had to repeat everything. But this reminds me of a very poor, I think it's a poor idea. It reminds me of the first class in theater school when people from 18, 19, 20 come from their little province places to Amsterdam or to Berlin, wanted to be an actor, and they have a teacher who gives them some lesson like this and they have to lose their ego or whatever. I think this is very poorly executed. This is a shame for the documentary, if you ask me, this whole exercise.
Yes, but the question for me is the question, why are we still going on? Why did we go on with it? Yeah. I have an uneasy feeling about it, but I have no idea what else we could do, so maybe that's a problem.
But I think it fits quite well in the concept of the documentary. I think nothing here is meant to make you comfortable or enjoy what you see. It's always making you think about it and think about it twice. What you experience in the first place may not be what's the intention in the second place. And maybe that's also the thing going on here. We, of course, obviously are not liking what's happening because it's giving us an uncomfortable position. But on the other hand, it's the subject of the group and the individual in the group. So this is actually what I think, what we have in many, many art things on the documentary to experience, that on the first hand it's maybe not interesting or maybe not exciting or making us feeling anything happy, but on the other hand it's making us think, and the process of thinking and rethinking what we usually think is maybe the goal of the documentary.
Could you speak up?
What is it making you think about, rather than maybe interesting to see the
way... Could you speak up, please?
Sorry. I said, what does it make you think about, or is it rather just interesting to see how so many different people from different walks of life are interacting together, and they don't really know why they're there, and they wonder what drew them into this room, and then you stay there thinking what's going to come out of it. And that's...
I find it quite interesting because it's the question what drives the group and what makes us come together. I think in the first place it was this social experiment and what needs to be the result of here, that we have to find a solution for something. And I think maybe it was even the goal that now we come together and get even closer and closer and get part of one group and is in this discussion.
Exactly what's going on here. That's what they wanted to do. You know, if we would have made this experience maybe in Africa or maybe in Europe and France, it would be completely different, I think. And so they would just do it and have fun. And here we just discuss. And I think that's typically, and it's yeah. Exactly what we said in German, dissonance, what we're talking about. And this is happening now.
Exactly.
Yeah, but I think dissonance is something which comes from like the frame they choose. If you want to get people together, you have to choose a room where you can understand each other, and you have to choose maybe a language that everybody understands, which is like not the case here, and a kind of frame where people can like come together in a way. And if you choose the complete different frame, which brings you in a different direction, and now think it's going to bring us to a, I don't know, kind of concept, social concept or something like this. And something comes from the group, but also something comes from the frame. And I don't know. The frame is like also the camera kind of thing, or what you said. I have the same experience with the theater thing that I, or what you said about like the embarrassment that is like. I don't know. Kind of. That would be happening nearly everywhere if you put random people together in the room. They would do like, let's clap our hands and let's like jump and let's say a word or something. Because it's the first thing you get in mind, which is totally fine. But it's also a deeper way of having a responsible hour together where you can really come together.
Well, I feel that this is happening every day. Mm-hmm. I mean, my personal perception is that in our everyday lives, everything is trying to keep us apart from each other. Like, we are encouraged to look for ourselves and to strive to achieve things and to be successful, and being in a collective process is not part of it. So, I think this is a very good example of how things work out there. Like, you have this very little power that says you do something, and although you think that it might be a bit stupid and boring, you still do it. Because it's the frame and it's there, and you don't have something to oppose it, or to propose something different.
But in this way, it's also like the kindness of the group which comes and says, okay, let's accept the rules they give us for the first time, let's try out, which you normally do when going into a performance. You try out first, and then maybe after half an hour you say, okay, I don't want to do it anymore. So.
I think we are going to have 5 minutes at all. And I would like to say, the setting is not splendid, not at all. You are absolutely right. I complained initially, and I became tense, I must say, when I was listening to everybody and I just heard noise. I'm an old man, okay, and my hearing is not the best one. But nevertheless, you should look after those people. Also after those people who don't want to lie down, who can't sit down. But on the other hand, you can't compare it with a theater playing school, an acting school, actor school, It's just impossible. It would be unfair at all. And I think one should see it by looking at the development of Documenta. I've visited the Documenta places since the middle 70s, and I never experienced anything like that, an interactive performance where people were asked to come together, to move. I was surprised that I had to move that much, and it helped, I think, to rethink my frame. So I would say, but thanks, it was marvelous that you started it. And you should encourage the Documenta people to get on with this kind of experiment. Not just this one, but more of them. It's lovely. And if we can't get down to the relationship between capitalism, as you wanted to see, and the personal relationship, okay, this can't happen within 1 hour and for the first time. Thank you very much. I would like to thank you.
I wanted to say that I think the relation between the capitalism and what was going on was very, very obvious the whole time today. Firstly, because it was told that we are here and our job is to entertain, which isn't, but okay. And it was also I felt it, that this problem of us asking from people to suggest and people waiting from something to happen and waiting from us to do something, which is reasonable from one side, but from the other side, it was obvious that we wanted suggestions and participation, I think. It was obvious from the start, I think. And also, what is also interesting is that we stopped repeating without us telling us to do so. We just stopped, and actually we really stopped because of you, taking your turn speaking and breaking this rule. And of course, we didn't try to bring back this rule, but when we started talking about it and about the structure and the rules, blah, 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 nobody pointed out that we stopped the repetition without us telling so. I mean, that we could have done it also earlier, maybe, or not.
For me, as you touch this subject, I want to say that it's, for me it's always very interesting how, when you don't have a rule or you don't, no one says what we have to do in this space, no one does anything. And when something is proposed as something that we do, there is an imitation that maybe it stops because for revolutionary subjects, sorry. We call people that they discover these mediations and they expose them, revolutionary subjects in this space. And we had you today to expose what was going on, so we could go over.
Yeah, well, the people who live in Paris, they also did it. So that's also kind of breaking.
No, we call them leavers. Kidding.
If you don't have anything, and if you have something, people repeat it until the end. Sometimes it gets very repetitive until the very end, but sometimes it's interesting for me when we have some breakthroughs like this, and this is what